Well, we're joined at the moment now by Ken Hancock, who's CEO at RLF AgTech. Ken, good morning to you.
Good morning. Great to be with you.
Good. Yeah, you too. Listen, a busy time for you guys. You've just completed your IPO and you're looking ahead to listing. Tell us a bit more about RLF AgTech. What is it you guys do and who you are?
Yeah, great. No, thank you. That's right. We just opened our offer this week and tracking for an April listing. So RLF AgTech is an Australian based provider of crop nutrition technology, and we've developed the that tech here in Australia and originally tested it across the major markets in Australia before launching into the international markets. Australia represents about 1% of the global crop nutrition market. So for us, it makes a lot of sense to be expanding into these very large export markets. So that's so over the last few years, we've had quite a focus on development, particularly in Asia, where we have over 100 staff on the ground now and revenues, and we're also profitable. So we're looking to really build on that base.
Yeah, it certainly looks encouraging. In terms of this IPO then, what more can you tell us about the deal itself? You know, what the motivation was behind that and why you're listing?
Yeah, so in terms of the actual quantum of money that we're raising 7 to 10 million during this listing, and the bulk of that funding is going into expansion of our sales and distribution network. We see the distribution network in Asia as being highly valuable as we can build that network out for our own product sales, but also allowing us to bring third party products into that channel. We've established around 400 distributors in the region at the moment, but if we take Asia as an example, I mean, there's over 310,000 fertilizer and chemical dealers that would be natural clients for us. So we've just touched the tip of the iceberg in our current business, but we've had good recurring revenue over recent years. And really looking to accelerate our growth in the international markets.
Yeah, let's talk a little bit more about Asia. You've got a lot of experience in the region. It is a major market for you guys. I mean, how interested do you expect investors to be in the advantages you have in that region, and specifically in China?
Look, I think there's some really good thematics in agriculture now, and tailwinds into the sector. We're looking at, you know, there's the fundamental long-term requirement for increased food security, and we need around 70% more food globally in the next 3 decades to meet food demand. Basically, the way that we've been doing that in agriculture historically is with granular fertilizer and pouring more fertilizer into the soil. We can't do that any longer because what we're seeing is not only yields not increasing, now in terms of more mature markets, there's a lot of environmental issues around these high rates of chemical fertilizers going in the soil. So we provide technology to overcome that. We can actually reduce those fertilizer inputs whilst increasing yield with our technology. We've been able to demonstrate across a lot of markets. So in terms of Asia, there's fantastic opportunity as the diets are changing. The higher protein diets, requiring more food to meet population growth, and here in Australia, we're really well positioned to take advantage of that key market. But we're not only in Asia; we've got we've had product sales into the Middle East, into North America. We've got some trial work going on in the US and South America. So there's a lot of areas for expansion in the future.
Yeah, certainly looks very interesting. Let's talk a little bit more about financials quickly. Can you give us an idea about where you guys currently stand in terms of things like revenue and what you're sort of looking ahead to?
Sure. Yeah. So we did essentially in 2019 and again in 2020, we did around the 10 million in revenue. We had in 2021, we did 8.5 million. That was due to some disruption in the supply and the distribution channels with COVID. But I'm really pleased to say that we've made a great recovery from that, with over a 45% increase in revenue to December 2021 for the first half. So we just had just come off a record first half, and that sets up really well for our major selling season in January to June each year. We also increased our EBIT position or EBITDA position last year in the 2021 year. So yeah, we're a company that we're not. I guess you know, in terms of tech-based companies, we're a company that does have revenue and profit. So we're not burning cash. We've got it, and we're really looking to accelerate our top line growth.
Yeah. All right. Well, let's talk about business growth. How do you see things panning out in the coming years, in particular in terms of your presence in the carbon market?
Yeah. So the carbon market's a really interesting one. We see a lot of opportunity about to come into I guess what you'd call the continuous cropping markets, is things like the grain sector. Say here in Australia, we've got around 23 million hectares of grain. Historically, grain producers haven't been part of the carbon generation side, but now with the soil carbon method here in Australia, there's now the opportunity for those growers to participate. We just saw that even recently, the Australian government has announced a good move in terms of, they'd been the major buyer of carbon credits, and they'd locked a lot of growers in at, say, $12 a tonne. But as recently as January, the price was $60 a tonne for carbon. 12 months ago, it was probably $6.50. So it's really, the market's been increasing. The Australian government has just allowed growers to take the market price rather than $12 a tonne that they've made. So that's great. That's going to return more money into landholders' hands. But from our own perspective, with our technology, we build soil carbon, and growers are going to need tech. They can't do that, which, you know, leads through to their ability to build their soil carbon.
Great. Well, certainly it does look very, very interesting indeed. All right. Look, you've got a busy period.
In terms of the markets, we're seeing record commodity prices, record fertilizer prices in the market. The growers really need to have technology available to them to change their practices and their input practices and be far more efficient. The future in agriculture is very much around nutrient use and water use efficiency to increase crop yields globally. And we, you know, we see as an Australian company, you know, we see a great opportunity internationally to really capitalize on what is close to a $280 billion market a year in crop nutrition. And so we're excited about our next stage and raising capital under the IPO and putting that into a focus on growth.
Great. Well, look, we look forward to seeing how it goes and hearing from you in the future.
Appreciate your time. Thank you.
Thanks, Ken. Bye-bye.